Okay, we've seen how we use the error flag in our flowchart and also how we, so that's how we check to see if there's an error, and this is how we trap that error by not executing these elements if the error flag has been raised. So now let's take a look at the code. So here's our code from before, and we're going to use the same thing we did, except since this is switch, not if, else, if, else, if, we need to add another case. So, whoops, not there. So we're going to have to add another case to this. So we can't say case trucks if we're looking for trucks. That wouldn't make any sense at all, because it could be any type of typographical error. So instead, we're going to use a keyword default. Oops, home row. A-U-L-T, there you go, default, colon. That says that, you know, I have a default value, that's a default value saying that's what's going to start with. It's saying that if there's nothing else there, do this. So the default is going to be two things. One is we're going to have to raise the error flag equals one. And we're going to have to output that error message. And we do that with something called an alert. Not the document write, because we want this just to pop up, not stay on the screen. And in here, we're going to be using this, so I might as well copy this and go back to my code and paste it in. All right, so now I have that. Now I'm missing something. And I guess I have to go over here. I need one more thing, and that default needs a break. This is the thing that students tend to forget, this break down here. If you don't, default runs, keeps running, and you end up with an error message. So be careful. As soon as you type in default, I should have done that. As soon as you typed in default colon, type break colon so you don't make sure you don't forget this. So again, let's preview it. And Susie. And she likes trucks. And you can see our error message comes up and shows what was typed, what needs to be typed. And then we have an error message, and that error message is because everything's gone to heck in a handbasket. So it can't do that final to fix because there's no number in that. So what we need to do then is mitigate it. So here, we want to say that if, and I shouldn't be typing, so if error flag, control C, control V, is zero, and again we have to put parentheses around this. Here's another danger zone. If we forget to put the equal here, like that, it assigns zero, and even if we have an error, it's still going to run this. So you want to make sure you have two equals, and then we do a start brace, start no errors, and then these should be tabbed over. But you know, if you don't do that, we're not going to take any points off. Whoops. Yeah. Well, that's a okay. And then we're going to have a stop brace. Stop, no errors. And then we're going to have an else. That else means that an error has occurred. So we have a start brace, start errors, and then a stop brace, stop errors. And what do we want to have in here? I'm going to go ahead and move this over so we can see more of it. We're going to take this. Actually, all we need is this part right here. I'm going to copy this, Control C, move this over, Control V, and in front of this, I'm going to put document write. So instead of an alert, I want this to stay on my screen. All right, well, let's see if this works or not. Okay, Susie, and let's do Susie truck. Uh-oh, error flag has not been defined. So let's go on. So it comes over here and it tries to do error flag equals zero. There's no such thing as error flag. And that's because we need to have it up in our variables. We never declared it. Remember, we grabbed it here. Now, it didn't cause an error here because JavaScript is so forgiving. But down here, it says, I can't figure this out. So what you do is we need to copy that and come up here and do var not equal equal here. So you want to assign zero to error flag. That means that we're going to start our code out with no errors. Now when it gets down here, if the error flag hasn't been tripped, then this will run. So let's go ahead and try it again. Okay, Susie wants a truck. And now it works perfectly because error flag equals zero. So this does the rest. Now let's go ahead and trip the error flag. Susie likes trucks. And then it gives us that error message. And then we have this at the very end. You typed trucks. So that's important that we leave this at the end because we don't want the user to... What happens when a pop-up comes? People just try to get rid of it. They don't even read it. Get it off my screen. But this stays on the screen until they rerun the application. And that's why we want to have it twice. We want to have an alert that lets them know an error has occurred and what it was. Then when the application ends, we want to also tell them that same information. So it didn't seem to make much sense here having this output here and this output here. And that's because both of these were pop-ups. But when we're doing our code, we can see that this is much more important to have this sitting on the screen, but we also want the user to know why the application broke, and that's because they have made an error. Like I said, once we start doing loops, this will change slightly because we want the application to keep running, not stop and have to restart again. So things are going to be slightly different once we get into the next lesson. But for this assignment coming up, again, you're going to be using switch for that. The only time you're going to be using error flag is when you're using switch. That's important to remember. In the real world, is that true? No. We have to check for every type of error in every piece of code that we have, but I don't want you going crazy. So just know that the only time that your instructor will be expecting you to do error checking is when you do a switch. All other times, don't worry about it. You don't need to. We just want to make sure that this is on your radar. If you do need more coding after this, just know that error checking and error trapping is going to be a big part of your coding. But here, I just want to make sure that we understand the principle of it and why it's so important. All right, that's it for this lesson.